Good morning and welcome to this Friday's edition of International Space Station Update. Bringing a close to the first week of Expedition 30's 2012, and they had quite a busy week doing a number of computer hardware upgrades and biomedical experiments and maintenance work. Starting off on Monday, the crew had an off-duty day, but Commander Burbank and Andre Kuipers did do some food container location work. In preparation for the SOLO experiment, SOLO standing for sodium loading, which helps to study the mechanisms of fluid and salt retention in the body during spaceflight. Andre, along with those nutrition activities, also prepared for his neurospat experiment, which he would perform throughout the week, and also doing a monthly hearing assessment. And then Don Pettit completed his work with the integrated cardiovascular experiment, which looks at atrophy of the heart muscle. And he finished that and then set up for his nutrition activities for the following day. On Tuesday, Commander Burbank continued with the EPIC hardware upgrades, EPIC standing for Enhanced Processor and Integrated Communications, which is a major overhaul of the processor cards in the guidance, navigation, and control and command and control computers onboard the International Space Station. He spent about 4 hours on Tuesday installing one of those cards. Anton Shkaplerov did some work with the Yurigan experiment. It is a Russian experiment that develops a sequence of visual observations for the Earth's surface, looking for natural and man-made disasters whenever they are forecasted. Anatoly Ivanishin, meanwhile, on Tuesday, did some photo and video work of the Russian-German Plasma Crystal 3 experiment, which was being worked on and executed by fellow Russian cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko. That Plasma Crystal 3 is a very complex experiment looking at wave propagation in dust plasmas. Meanwhile, on Tuesday, Andre Kuipers did some work with the NeuroSpat experiment, being assisted by Don Pettit. That experiment, he affixed a number of sensors to his brain, and then using a few other mechanisms, was testing his prefrontal brain functions and spatial cognition, helping to determine the effects of that microgravity environment on decision-making. And then, along with that, he began his own integrated cardiovascular setup, again, looking at the heart muscle's atrophy. Also assisting with that NeuroSpat experiment, Don Pettit did some human research facility sample collection. And moving on to Wednesday, Dan Burbank continued working with the CUCU, which stands for COTS UHF Communication Unit, which will be the main source of communication between the International Space Station and visiting vehicles from commercial resuppliers scheduled to launch later this year. He also participated in a public affairs event alongside with Don Pettit and Andre Kuipers talking to some reporters here on the ground. Anton Shkaplerov did some house cleaning work over in the Russian Zarya module, cleaning some filters and changing out some ventilation screens, as well as beginning his work on the bar experiment, which took up much of his time this week. The bar experiment is a Russian look at selection and testing of different detection methods for detecting any potential depressurization onboard the International Space Station modules. Meanwhile, on Wednesday, Anatoly Ivanishin did some work on the Electron, or the oxygen generation system, on the Russian segment, and also participated in that bar experiment. Oleg Kononenko continued his work with Plasma Crystal 3 on Wednesday, and Andre Kuipers continued his work with the integrated cardiovascular, donning a number of sensors and cardiopressed gear, again taking his heart readings. And along with that, Kuipers also did some trash gathering for disposal on the ISS Progress 45 cargo craft, which is scheduled to undock in about 3 weeks. Don Pettit assisted with that trash gathering and then familiarized himself with the vessel imaging, which he worked on today. Moving on to Thursday, Commander Burbank continued with his EPIC card upgrades, spending the entire day in order to replace the cards in one of the guidance, navigation, and control computers and command and control computers. And he was assisted by Don Pettit, who did a number of cable routings installing Ethernet cords for the systems. Meanwhile, Shkaplerov and Ivanishin continued with that bar experiment, as well as doing some routine maintenance work in the Zvezda, or service module, on the Russian segment, looking at the windows and ventilation systems. And then their fellow Russian cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko continued his work with the Plasma Crystal 3 for the third day in a row, and then also did the Siner experiment, taking a look at the world's oceans. And then the last two crew members on Thursday, Kuipers and Pettit, did some work on the water recovery system, and Kuiper's also took some time out to do his own media event, talking to Dutch reporters in his native Netherlands. And all of that brings us to today, Friday, the last day of the week, with Commander Burbank spending the vast majority of his day stowing all of the equipment from those epic software upgrades having been completed, and also taking some time out to do a public affairs event alongside with Don Pettit, talking to reporters here in the U.S. And then moving on through the crew, Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin are doing their third day of the bar experiment, again looking at potential methods for detecting depressurization on board the International Space Station, and also doing some inspection and photography work on the Zvezda or service module's windows. Oleg Kononenko is doing some experiment work on his own today, working with the Pneumo card, which is a Russian experiment, kind of similar to that integrated cardiovascular you heard me talking so much about, studying the adaptation of the cardiovascular system of these crew members during their long-duration microgravity flights. He will also be working with the Rusalka experiment, an Earth observations experiment, which looks to understand the role of natural processes in human activity, and then determines carbon dioxide and methane content in the Earth's atmosphere. Andrei Kuiper's spending his day working on some of the nano racks on board the International Space Station, doing some experiment routines with some smartphones that were recently flown up to the station, and then assisting Don Pettit with some of his ultrasound activities. And then those ultrasound activities will take up a majority of Pettit's days today. He will be doing three separate scans, one for the integrated cardiovascular, taking an ultrasound of his heart, as well as doing something called the sprint ultrasound, taking a look at the thigh and calf muscles on his leg, and again studying how the muscles have changed during spaceflight. His last ultrasound of the day will be the vessel imaging, taking a look at the vessel wall properties within his own body, and one of those ongoing looks at the cardiovascular functions inside astronauts during these long-duration space flights. Crew is scheduled to go to sleep at about 3:30 p.m. Central Time today, and that will bring a wrap to their first week of 2012 on board the International Space Station.